A question that I've also been asked to ask, which I would also like to ask, is June 12th.
Yeah.
June 12th was considered one of the fairest elections we've ever had in this country. And at the time, you were the head of state, and June 12th was not. Why?
I have always said, I looked at June 12th in two ways. The first one, at least for once, Nigerians accepted that it was the freest, the best organized election, free, fair, and so on, all equitable. I think what is missing is, unfortunately, we canceled that election.
You said unfortunately?
Yeah. That's the first time I'm using that word.
I picked it up, unfortunately.
Okay. Unfortunately, the elections were not recognized or were announced, as the media would like me to say. Now, we were in government at that time. And we knew the possible consequences of handling that, of handing over that government to a democracy, to a democratic government. Now, get me right, I didn't say to
the person.
To the person.
The process.
The process. And we had, when the process was going on, we did swear that ours was going to be the last military coup that we were going to handle. And so we wanted to make sure we handed power to every, to a democratically elected government. To be honest, the situation was not ripe to hand over at that time. Forget about the wrong things that the political parties have. No, that is not the issue.
What was the issue? What
the issue was the security of the nation. And we considered that we would have failed after handing over power 6 months is kicked out.
What was the security threat?
Security threat is that at that time we, there was all this fear. I went through a coup d'etat. I survived a coup d'etat. We did not want it to happen.
So there was likely to be another coup.
Right. And it is going to be, it would have been a bit bloody. But then, not many people want to believe what we said. But we knew what was...
Could I ask who the plotters were? Do you know who they were?
The plotters were the usual coup plotters. You know, they could have allowed me to go away. And then regroup. And stage a coup.
When you say the usual, the usual, I don't know.
The usual coup plotters.
Oh, okay.
They are the military now. This thing happens. There is always a man who will come out and complain to say this is wrong. We can't have it. And such a man will always try to convince you, to convince everybody who is here that this is wrong. This is how you build it.
So that was it? So they just let him go through the process and then...
Just blessed by time. We, again, I am aware I'm going to be in trouble with the outside world. We knew in 1983,
that
when you had an election and Shagari was voted in, as his second term as a democratically elected president. We could have toppled that government in 1982 before the elections. But then we said, no, the people might go against us. We knew damn well that they are not, or they were not going to conduct that election truly and fairly. And therefore, you see, to stage a coup, there is one basic element that everybody looks for. Frustration in the society.
Frustration in the society.
Right. So by 1983, when you voted, everybody was not happy. It was rigged, it was this, it was that. And the frustration built up. We find coup easier when there is frustration in society.